So let's take a look at setting up your Intercom profile. You can access your profile settings by clicking on the profile picture at the bottom of the screen and then clicking on your name. So you can see, because I'm a new member of a workspace, that I have no picture set here yet. So let's start by making sure my customers know that they're speaking with a real person. In Intercom, this profile picture will appear beside any of the conversations you're having, and it also shows at the top of the messenger where customers can see the members of your team who've been most recently active. So to add your photo, just click on the picture here and add a photo of yourself. So here are some I have created earlier. You'll get to preview these as well, just to make sure that you're happy with the picture before it's uploaded. So I'm going to click OK on this. And my photo has been uploaded, and you'll see how it will appear to customers in a chat, in a conversation to you in the inbox, and in the messenger here to show who's available on your team. You can add more detail to your profile right here too. So just click on edit and you can change your name. You can change the email address that will appear here. You can also change whether or not you want your location to be seen by the people you're chatting to. You can add your job title, or you can add a little bio about yourself so the customers can get to know you a little bit better. If you want to create meetings with customers, you can also add a link to a calendar with any of the integrations like Google Calendar or Outlook that we provide. And you can also add a link to your Twitter handle if you'd like to do that too. I'm going to update some of these and we'll see what that looks like in my profile on Intercom. So I will add customer support agent. I'm going to say, love to help our customers achieve success. I'm not going to add a link to my calendar, and I'm not going to add my Twitter handle for now. So let's click done. And we'll see what that looks like to my customers. So now that my workspace is starting to feel a little bit more personal, let's take a look at some of the other options you might want to set up. So we can check this out by clicking on our avatar again and clicking on your account. So here you can see where I can change some details on my account, like the email address on file. I can upload a new picture if I want to, or I can change my password or set up two-factor authentication, which is always a great idea to make your account a little bit more secure. Next up, let's take a look at some of the notification settings. Once you start to have lots of conversations, getting notified for all activity in multiple ways can be pretty overwhelming. So if we click in here, we can take a look at the different types of notifications and the different events we'd like to be receiving notifications for. So here you can see there's three different notification types for all the different events that we list down here on the left. You've got desktop, which means you'll get a little browser notification like this. You've got mobile, which is if you're using the mobile inbox app on iOS or Android. And then you've got email. Now, email notifications will be received to the email address that we have on file. And if you're having a conversation, you'll only receive a notification of activity in that conversation if you've not been active for a couple of minutes in the Intercom app, just to bring you back and let you know that there has been some activity. So make sure that you check which ones are right for you. Right now, I'm going to leave it as the default notification settings, but make sure you take a little bit of time to make sure this is going to work for you. Or if you're part of a larger team, make sure that this is in line with how your team receives their notifications normally. So let's take a look down here for some of the more subtle notification options, which will change how we'll receive notifications in the browser. So these are better than just receiving a big notification on desktop for everything. You can make sure your browser will just blink. You can make sure it makes a sound. You can turn off the sound if you're a little bit more sensitive to that. And you can change how and when you'll receive these notifications. So if something is received into an unassigned conversation inbox, you can receive a notification for every one of those. Again, that could be a little bit heavy, so you might want to tweak this. You can change the sound you'll receive notifications for and make sure that it is something that appeals to you or cuts through the noise that you've got in the office or at home. You can opt in to get a daily email which lists all the new signups to your business. This can be really helpful if you're running a small startup and you want to get that involved with every single new user. And finally, you can opt to receive updates about our app store, which is where all our apps and integrations live. And this helps make sure Intercom is part of your entire tech stack. So take a little time to make sure these notification settings are working for you. And if you ever need to tweak them in future, you can always come back here again. And that's it. Those are the most important settings to set up in your profile. Now you're ready to start chatting with customers.